I think most of my work is, I view them as homage pieces to friends and family. And I had done a lot of portraits of people and friends hanging out. It seems to be like a lot of the same recurring themes of friends that are inhabiting these subcultural social spaces. I was asking some of my friends about these sort of gothic lunchboxes that I remember having when I was a young person, I think in high school. And they were these little like lunchboxes that you put your stickers of different bands as a way to show your affiliation or what you liked. I remember these, and I guess as I'm getting older, remembering it kind of being nostalgic a little bit. So I was asking some of my friends, and they still had their lunchboxes. And I thought it would be great to document it, kind of harkening back to a specific era, maybe the early 90s, late 80s. And each sticker kind of has its own content or context attached to it as well. So there's a story within each drawing. So it's kind of like a portrait of them through their lunchboxes. Tattooing was a way to make money and to support my art practice, I think, and it's been really great, and it's actually brought me back to what I originally was really inspired by as an artist. It's talking to people, connecting with people, finding their stories, and the tattoo is kind of like this collaborative piece between me and the person who's getting it, and we discuss where it goes on the body, what it means for the person, and it's this really nice kind of way to share that experience, and it's very like cathartic and therapeutic and spiritual in a lot of ways. It's a really nice balance between the studio and here where I'm alone and drawing, and there I have this dialogue with somebody as I'm creating, and so it's become like a really amazing day job to have and really positively influencing a lot of my art practice. See, for me, because culture is so varied, and it's not necessarily like this one monolithic idea of Japanese American identity and this one monolithic Chicano identity, because each one is so varied and different, and each experience is so varied and not going to be the same from another person's. So it's hard for me to like specify like this is definitely this specific culture I'm referencing here, because each culture on its own is influenced by so many different cultures as well. I think in my work that dialogue always exists, but I'm not necessarily, I guess, trying to flesh it out or make sense of it, because I think it is so complex and so varied that it would almost be impossible to.